I love a challenge. I love being scared. I love creatively being scared. I love that. So I love reaching in and touching these worlds I've never touched before and saying, damn, I hope I can pull it off. It's great. I get paid to touch these worlds and experience these worlds, and it's fun, it's exciting. And then I give all that information to my actors. So it's a great shorthand. I don't know how many directors actually do it. A lot of guys talk about doing it, but they don't give the time to do it. And I give the time to do it because I love doing it. And I give that to my, I give that, those worlds to my actors. And it's a, because it's very abstract talking to an actor like Denzel. Well, I think you should play the scene this way. You should have this haircut. You should wear these sunglasses. You can forget all of that once you know what the interior of the personality is. And once we've found that guy, it's so much easier. So I find one person for every one of my actors.
Yes, I read you, Pelham 123. This is Control Center. Who is this?
It's me, man.
My world is driven by the world I touch through my characters, you know, and so that's stylistically, I'm always dictated to by the world I'm touching. So, you know, when I did Domino, you know, Domino was all the bounty hunters I met were on speed. So Domino, the whole movie, like, it's on speed, it's on crystal meth, it's all like that, you know. So so that was style is dictated to by character or by the world I'm touching, and that's why I like to touch, you know, touch those worlds in different ways.
In 2003, I was named Bounty Hunter of the Year.
I think I'm a fear addict, fear junkie, fear of failure, and it's fear of failure, creative failure, you know. So, and creative failure in my mind, you know, and I get hammered by the press, I get killed by the press, they destroy me. You know, so ever since The Hunger, my first movie, which has now become a cult movie, I got slagged off on the Hunger, and I couldn't get arrested. Hollywood did the same. England destroyed me. Hollywood destroyed me, and it took me 4 more years to get another movie, you know, which was Top Gun. And Don Simpson was actually, he was channel surfing. Don and Jerry were partners then, was channel surfing at like 3 a.m. in the morning. He saw The Hunger came up, and he said, maybe this guy knows what he's doing, you know. And I'd actually done a commercial for Saab, which is a jet chasing a car. So I was the only guy that actually shot jets as well. And the combination of he thought he knew what he was doing with The Hunger and jets, I got the movie. Creatively, you know, I started my life off as a painter. I spent 8 years in art school painting. And I still think like a painter, a director. Directing is very similar, actually. It's all about making choices. Well, it's very similar. The process hasn't changed. And the studios hate to hear that when you say, I still think like a painting, now you're doing a $100 million movie.
Who is this?
This is a man who's going to give the city a run for the money. Now, what is the price for New York City hostages this morning?
I was at Sunderland Art School. I was painting, and I was the head of the film society, which basically meant I ran the projector, you know, on a Friday night, and we got all these films in. We got Polanski films in, we got Bertolucci films in, we got Fellini films in. But I think Nick Rogue was actually my the guy I stole from the most. Yeah. And so Nick I've stolen from you many times, yeah. And a film called Performance with Mick Jagger and James Fox is a great movie. That I've stolen from many times in terms of The Hunger was a direct knockoff of Performance. And I called Nick up and I said, I'd have stolen directly from me. He said, well, dear boy, if you did a good job, I don't mind. But no, there's a lot of people out there influencing me. My brother had a huge influence. You know, really, he's a little older than I am, and I helped him make his first movie when he was at art school, and he helped me make my first movie. So. And I gravitated from painting to film.
And action!
When I finished at the Royal College, he said, you know, you owe a lot of money, because I was 8 years in art school. He said, we started up this commercial production company. You know, come and do commercials while you continue looking at your feature career. So I started doing commercials, and I didn't look back for 10 years. I did 10 years straight, and I cornered into the market, which was girls, jeans, rock and roll. And it was a wild period in advertising. It was more like rock videos today. And it was a blast. Then I said, after 10 years, damn, I should be, you know, re-looking at film again.
The writer wants to talk to you.
Right.
Are you sure you don't have some sort of relationship with him?
Well, I can assure you, whatever relationship I have with him is better than yours. Jerry, my friend, was killed while you were talking to the writer, so maybe that's a question you should ask yourself instead of asking me.
at that point in time, the British directors are not truly represented in Hollywood, and there's this weird snobbery about commercial directors. And then people like Alan Parker, Ridley, Hugh Hudson, Adrian Lyne, and myself came along, and we put British directors back on the map for that period when it was a little soft in terms of our representation in Hollywood, you know. And also I put Jerry Bruckheimer in that mix because Jerry had the guts and the balls to you know, give Adrian a movie called Flashdance. You know, and Adrian and I compared notes. I was given the movie called The Hunger, and I said, and he was given a movie called Flashdance. We exchanged. I read The Flashdance, and said, this is terrible. And he gave me The Hunger. And we exchanged, and he called me up one day, and he said, you know what? I've got it. There's this program called MTV, and it runs 12 hours a day. And I'm going to do 12 hours of MTV for Flashdance. And that's what he did, and it was great. It was great. It was a huge commercial hit. So, but we're always criticized, not so much Alan. Alan somehow escaped that commercial directors going into feature. Ridley and I got nailed in terms of, we got crucified in terms of style over content, you know, because we were more style than Alan. But Alan's, you know, is a great director. And Hugh Hudson as well, he escaped that being slagged off, saying, you know, style over content. Yeah, but Ridley got crucified. Adrian got crucified, and so did I, more than Rid. But we wouldn't have been represented in the film market in that era unless we'd come out of advertising.
Worst thing in the world is to be caged up. That boy's been there, and he ain't never going back, even if it costs him his life.
I don't socialize. I don't function in Hollywood. I function out of my office, I've got this cocoon. I've got this sort of little space that I occupy. But if you look at, especially the latter movies, I'm a gypsy. You know, I just spent 6 months in New Orleans, which wasn't like being in America. New Orleans is like Madrid or Paris or Mexico City. I spent a year in Mexico City. I spent a year in Europe, and 6 months of that was in Morocco. You know, so I'm like this gypsy, and I don't really feel part of the Hollywood culture or part of that system. I feel as though I'm doing my thing, and I'm being embraced and being paid by Hollywood, and it's great. You know, I'm never going to get an Oscar. You know, I think, you know, I'm just sort of, I'm not even on the radar. Yeah, because I think my style or how I began, or I think I've tarnished my slate way too early with The Hunger. You know, it's my first movie, so I'm sort of dismissed. So Tony Scott. But Ridley did good. He did good. He broke the mold with Gladiator. Yeah, but I'm not. I'm sort of dismissed. I've been scrubbed off the list.
Life is simple now. You just have to do what I say.
Call the mayor now.
Somebody just hijacked Pelham 123.
You don't think this was fate, you and me?
You know, I'm just a guy. I'm just a guy on the other end of the mic.
I do like you, man. You may be the last friend I ever make.
What really interests me is, as I say, most of all, is getting me feeling good about what I've done, and me and the people that I work with feeling good about what I've done. So my family, my family and the broad scope, my crew. I work with the same crew now for, God, 15, 20 years, you know. And that's what I call my indirect family. I wanna feel good in that family community.